Hi, welcome to another week of Thinkercise. This week we have Pedro Castro with us. I am Yasser Altimimi.
I'm Iris Garon.
I'm Trevor Dykstra.
Thinkercise is a weekly challenge brought to you by our favorite designers. Every week is a different design, different challenge, and a different design. So for this week, we have Pedro with us. How are you, Pedro?
Doing great. I'm happy to be part of the game.
Welcome. So, Pedro, you are an architect and the founder of Imagine Land Architects. Tell us, what does an architect do?
Oh gosh, what does architect don't do? I think that'll be a better question. We do a lot of stuff, you know? A very great question. And I think if you look at an architect as the maestro of the band, right? So everybody think about the architect as the creative guy, but actually the architects, one of our jobs is to coordinate the whole team of folks that will execute somebody's vision, right? So that can be as simple as your house or way to your airport. So our role is to be the orchestrator, not just the creator, which is something not very well emphasized, right? People always look at the architect as the artist, but we take a major role of organizing the whole band. And in my opinion, that's what makes it very exciting, because the problem solving is not just the design scale, it's putting the whole puzzle together, right? And a lot of things that people don't talk, and I have five things that I always go through, is like, okay, basic functions of architecture, right? Understanding the scope. So the architect plays a huge role in that, because by the architect understand the scope, he will definitely understanding who's going to be part of this game. So part of the five basics here is understand the scope, understand the budget, which by the way, unfortunately, when you go to the school of architecture, is no budget. And then you get to the real world, that is budget. Also on the school of architecture, nobody talk about timeline. Oh gosh, there's a deadline. So I always remind the people. So architects also police the money, the time, and the team. Back to my statement about organize the team, right? And also we're responsible to manage the risk, which that many people don't want to talk about. So back to your question, what does architect do? We do a lot of stuff, right? Not getting to the minutia of each single one. And of course, design aside, there's many components, not getting to every single piece, but we are organizing this whole team that can execute somebody's vision.
Absolutely. That's an amazing answer. And I would like you to tell us more about Magellan Architects and your journey through the past 35 years here.
Well, you know, let's start with the name, right? My name is actually, I simplified to Pedro Castro, but
yeah,
it's actually Pedro de Magalhães Castro. And Magalhães is actually the proper Portuguese spelling. By the way, I'm a Latino by the definition being the south of the border. But as you know, Brazil is a little unique. We don't speak Spanish, we speak Portuguese.
Absolutely.
And one of my idols was actually Magellan. The guy was crazy. He traveled the world, you know, and the amazing drive that he had. And I think that's part of the when I captured the name Magellan was to be the explorer, right? So I found the company in 2000, and now 20 years later,
amazing,
fairly believing in that. I also opened another office in California, following this vision to be the explorer, opened an office in Dallas, Texas, and we just opened a satellite office in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil.
Wow.
And my vision is to keep multiplying the Magellan family. So it's been an interesting ride. I mean, very challenging. Nothing is easy on this planet. And especially now that we're dealing with the corona. But guess what? Having the spirit of being explored, the solution provider, and try to find a ways of surviving. I was just talking to a friend of mine. I said, my dad passed away, and all my siblings took his inheritance. So I have to make it happen, because I don't have allowance for my dad, and I cannot collect unemployment. I got to make it happen. Guess
no
what?
No choice.
Here you go. You know, and actually one of my mission now, I've been calling myself, I hate titles, but I want to be migrated to CEO, but the CEO stands for Chief Explore Officer. And my goal moving forward is finding architects and designers that would like to propel themselves from technicians to managers and ownership, and I'll be the person helping them doing that. So my goal is to keep multiplying with more Magellans. And the number one requirement is find people with the fire in the belly. I don't care how good you are technically. You have to be technically competent, but you have to have the desire. I want to be the owner. I want to be the guy taking the higher risk. And that's how I'm going to, so I'm going to be going to have, you know, the, you know, I don't know for how long I'm going to be doing that, but knowing myself, I don't think I'm going to be slowing down soon. So.
That's great, amazing. Great. So what, with such a great story about how you got to where you were, what made you want to become an architect? Yeah. As you said, it's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot. I first of all, this not a disclaimer, but it's something to add to the conversation. My father was an architect, but as a good rebel, you know, you have to go against your father. So I did everything I could not to be an architect. But then my mom, which is very nice lady, said, "You know, why are you rebelling so much? Why don't you try to be, you know, why don't you try to architecture?" And in Brazil, like in Japan, I don't care if your GPA is 4.0 and you're amazing high school, you do have to pass a test. If you don't pass the test, you don't go. So on one of the options was engineering, the other one was become an attorney, and the other one was architecture. And my mom said, "No, there's this private school I'll pay for, apply and see what happened." And I did apply, I passed the test, it was a private school in Brazil, Rio de Janeiro. Apply, pass to the architecture school. And then I realized how fascinating the profession is. So like I said, besides the design piece, you actually become an attorney because you got to read a lot of codes and regulations and deal with a lot of stuff, right? So, and there's the engineering piece, which is the other place I was going after. So I thought, you know, actually, I do like that. And I keep going through the architectural program. And 5 years later, I graduate with a bachelor's in architecture in Brazil. And actually, FYI, at 24 years old, I opened my first architecture firm in Brazil, even before I graduated, called PAMC, which is my initials in Brazil. And that was my first architecture firm. And interesting story, I actually made a lot of money in Brazil, sold everything to my dad. And I said, "Look, I think I want to go learn English," because my dad said, "You have to learn English if you want to go to the next level." And he paid me for English class, but I was always end up in a bar drinking and never took the class very seriously. So anyway, so I end up packing my bag, and I have a visa, you know, student tourist visa to come to US, and put everything in a backpack, cash in my pocket. I sold my motorcycle, my tools to my dad, everything to him. Passed the keys to my office to a couple of friends. I said, "Look, I'll come back in 6 months. You guys can run the office for me." I never went back. So I've been here for 33 years now. So
it's fascinating.
That's great. Thank you.
You know what? I think we should, given time here, we should transition on to what we're going to be doing this week. So
yeah,
cool.
Pedro, I'll let you intro it. I know you've shared some slides that I can share, but what is our audience going to be designing this week?
Guys, we have something very, very exciting. You know, everybody knows what acupuncture is, right?
Sure.
So, and the idea of acupuncture is to release the pressure, release the pain. And we are going through such a crazy time right now. You know, the riots, the corona. I feel like we are in a lot of pain right now. So the challenge for this week is to poke the needle in our city, in our community. So that it's gonna call the urban acupuncture. You're gonna be go there and poke the needle. And I gotta give an example. So We're not talking about designing a major structure. We may be designing a rigid umbrella, right? Something done in metal, something done differently. And the umbrella, we can poke that into a park or the corner of your neighborhood, right? And that can be done on a residential neighborhood. It can be done on a park. So is a park inside of a park, or is a sculpture with the function of attracting the community to be around this needle. So that is the main goal. So it may be another example. You may design a little domino block. You know, it may be people bring three and they become benches, right? So then you can be, I don't know, a good size one that can become a bench. It can be just a dice, and the dice can become a bench or something to play with. It can be used as a landscape feature. It can be a game. But that is the little piece that is going to be introduced to our community. I did put a PowerPoint showing some inspiring options, but I'm going to be dying to find what will people do, right? It might be a little gathering place that people can say, okay, let's meet at this X at the city, right? So, and I think the question is, what's the vision in terms of execution? Is that gonna be people doing sketches, or are they actually physically building? And my advice to you is, yeah, architecture, oh, here's the umbrella, right? But my idea would be, you know, take the full scope. Architects are not just hired to design, they are hired to produce a structure. So if you want to design and you don't know how to execute, maybe somebody will execute for you. I always look at Boy Scouts of America, right? They're always desperate to do little projects for the Eagle Scout. So maybe we can introduce that to the Boy Scout of America, or to the school, or to whoever. So the job is not just a sketch exercise, a sketch migrating to execution. And because of the scale, it's doable, right? Anybody would be able to do that. And people may find sponsors, right? So to build the dice or the umbrella or the domino piece, you may go to Home Depot, say, Home Depot, do you want to be the sponsor for that piece, right? So now it's just going to be the labor of producing that. So that's my couple cents for the week. What do you guys think?
That sounds exciting. Yeah, that's going to be different from the other ones so far.
It's a tougher challenge, for
what
sure.
What do you expect from Magellan?
Exactly.
Absolutely not.
No, oh. I'm excited to see what people will do. So if you're listening at home, can you go outside? Can you find a spot in your neighborhood or in front of your home or even around your home to impact that environment in some small way? I like that the slide we shared there with the newspaper box, but it's been turned into a planter, you know.
There you go.
It's what else are they doing with those? Right?
Yeah. The remnant of a bygone era. Sort of.
The telephone booth. I see the other day a telephone booth that is abandoned, right? What can that be done? I mean, you know, somebody will come with a good idea. Like I said, it's not our job to get the good ideas. It's the public that's going to watch this. The people are going to get excited and motivated and say, okay, that dilapidated telephone booth can be something else, right? Like the newspaper stand. So it'll be very cool to see what's going to come up out of this exercise.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's excellent. Well, Zoom is telling me we've got seven less ticking clock minutes left. I do want to get to our final question before we go. And we've asked this every week, and it's evolving, hopefully, to something simpler. So the question is, the festival's theme this year is About Time. We've been thinking about time and thinking about where we were when we started our careers, maybe where we're going. But for you, Pedro, you've talked about where you were when you started, especially started fairly early, 24 for a firm. What advice would you give that person now? If you could talk to 24-year-old Pedro, what would you tell them? You know, what would you want them to remember as of now?
Time, you know, time goes by fast. So, but one thing about time is you as an individual have a gift from God, which is 24 hours. Bill Gates has 24 hours. Steve Jobs had 24 hours. You know, Jeff Bezos has 24 hours. What do you do with your 24 hours? That's the question, right? You can be a drug addict in the side of the street and waste your life, or you can do something great to your life. And to do something great to your life, I'm a true proponent of setting goals for yourself. I was in Brazil and I said, I'm going to go to America to learn English. And, you know, and when I got here learning English, I decided to get a master's in architecture. When I got a master's in architecture, I decided to open my office. I opened my first office. I opened my second office. Now I opened my third office. So I'm always setting goals and always challenge yourself, right? Humans need to be challenged. They are creative creatures. And as soon as you put goals in front of yourself, you always try to achieve those goals or hit those goals. So now I have four offices. I'm not going to stop in four offices, right? So I learn English. Now I want to learn Italian. You know, you read one book. You can see behind me here books, right? What is that right there? You read another book, right? So you meet somebody else. And that, guys, you know, I'm an adventure motorcycle rider. So I rode my motorcycle to Alaska, all the way down to Brazil. I crossed all the Americas on my motorcycle. Now I produce a documentary called Baja Bound with my sons. He's driving motorcycles in Mexico on a $900 motorcycle. That's not a $40,000 Harley Davidson. So if you go to YouTube and say Baja Bound, you see my new documentary going on. Right, set goals for yourself. Get excited about life. Don't waste your time with, you know, things that be harmful to you. Help people surround you, right?
Amazing.
And that's what life is all about. So and you fulfill your time engaging in life, inspiring people, and have a lot of blast. Because like I said, we talk about the 24 hours. People had 24 hours. You know, Steve Jobs, his 24 hours expired, right? And we never know. I don't care how many billions you have. One thing we know, one day the clock's going to stop. So have a blast.
Excellent
advice.
That's
really inspiring.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to watch Baja Bound on YouTube.
Yeah, well, I was just about to ask.